The seventh witness to the innocence of the Christ came from the Trinity. Unexpectedly, huh? But not the baptism of Jesus. I say the Trinity because both the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit bore witness to the innocence of Jesus. The Father at the baptism of Jesus says, "This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased." If he pleases Father, who are you? Who is the media? Who are the politicians? Who are the so-called scientists who are still searching for evidence? He pleases Father. Father says, "This is my Son. He pleases me." When a holy God says, "He pleases me," that means he's innocent. The Son himself, St. John's Gospel, chapter 8, verse 46, he is having a little banter as usual with the scribes and the Pharisees. Amen. And they are accusing him. You got a devil. You're a Sabbath breaker. You're an imposter. You're a false Christ. Jesus said to them, in front of their face, "Which of you can convince me of sin?" The Christ himself bears witness to his innocence and to his sinlessness. And thirdly, Jesus says, when the Holy Spirit comes, he is the Spirit of truth. He also will testify of me. Thus, we have the whole Trinity testify to the innocence of the Christ. But brothers and sisters, as an innocent lamb, as a harmless lamb, he must go to the slaughter for your sins and my sins. And that's why he had to suffer like that day. But brothers and sisters, not only did the Trinity bear witness to Jesus individually at various times, the Trinity collectively bore witness to the innocence of Jesus on resurrection morning. Because you see, if Jesus was not an acceptable sacrifice, if he was not a sinless Savior, if he was not perfect, and if he had not perfectly kept the law, he would not have been an acceptable sacrifice. But because the atoning sacrifice, for the sins of the human race, by the perfect sinless Lamb of God, was accepted by the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the Bible says, therefore death could not hold him. Amen. Because the wages of sin is death, and the strength of sin is the law. And he went into the jaws of death, into the bowels of the earth, into the very clutches of death itself. But death never placed its clutches upon a sinless man before. From the time of Adam down to the time of Christ, and even unto this day, death always places his hand upon sinful beings like you and me. Because death came as a result of sin. But that day, when the clutches of death hold the sinless Lamb of God, death could no longer hold him, because he's guiltless, because he's innocent. Despite Pilate's judgment, despite the Sanhedrin's conniving and venomous hatred and bitterness towards him, brothers and sisters, regardless, no witness came forward to bear evidence to his innocence. Death could not hold this man. Death itself said, "This is a sinless man. Loose him, let him go."
Hallelujah.
And he came out of the tomb. Brothers and sisters, and the scripture attributes the resurrection to the Father. For the Bible says God the Father raised him from the dead. The Bible attributes the resurrection to the Son. For Jesus says, "I will raise myself from the dead."
Amen.
And the Bible attributes the resurrection to the Holy Spirit. For the Bible says the same Spirit that raised Christ from the dead,
amen,
when he dwell in you, he will also quicken your mortal body.
Amen.
So brothers and sisters, today as we celebrate resurrection, resurrection is a testimony and an evidence and a witness from God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, that Jesus was innocent.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Now, brothers and sisters, after he rose from the dead, The scribes and Pharisees are still searching for witnesses, and they can't find any. Now, because he came out of the tomb, they are searching for witnesses to say, no, he did not come out from the tomb. Up to this week, I heard on the radio, the Time magazine, and I think it was Newsweek or some one of those magazines, reputable magazines, somebody was quoting from it. They're saying that no modern mind can accept the scientific theory because it's not scientific of the resurrection of Christ and all this nonsense. Brothers and sisters, he did live. And he lived spotless. Hallelujah. And he lived sinless. Hallelujah. And he kept the law to the letter. Hallelujah. And he was the innocent Lamb of God. Hallelujah. Why did he have to die? Because you and I were heading down to a lost eternity. Amen. Amen. Brothers and sisters, I know no other Jesus than the Jesus of the Bible. Hallelujah. The angels testify and say, this same Jesus Hallelujah. Will come again one day. Amen. Back to my point. The Jews as a result. They came to the soldiers. I came across something this week I didn't ever notice before. Matthew 28 verse 62 says these words. Now the next day, that followed the day of the preparation. That's the Sabbath day. The chief priests and the Pharisees came together unto Pilate saying, sir, we remember that deceiver said, while he was yet alive, after 3 days, I will rise again. Command, therefore, that the sepulchre be made sure until the third day, etc., etc. Amen. Now, brothers and sisters, look at this. Look at the irony. Jesus is being crucified, or he was crucified, because amongst one of the things that they had against him, he is a Sabbath breaker. Now, the same chief priest and the council who enforces the Sabbath, what are they doing? After the day of the preparation is the Sabbath. On the Sabbath day, they came to Pilate. Amen. If you read the story, before that, when they brought Jesus to Pilate, for Pilate to try him, they would not go into the judgment hall because they says, we don't want to go in Gentile territory because we will be defiled. Tomorrow is the Sabbath and the Passover. So we don't want to break the Sabbath and defile ourselves. We wouldn't have time to sanctify ourselves so that we can keep the Passover. Now after Jesus rose from the dead, on the Sabbath day, while Jesus was in the tomb, these same chief culprits are breaking the Sabbath. They probably traveled a Sabbath day's journey. They obviously made a transaction with Pilate that was illegal, not permitted. Are you following this?
Amen.
So guilty people are seeking witnesses to ensure that the Christ remains in the tomb. Now, when they found the soldiers testified that, listen, this is what happened. They were ready to go into the church treasury and pay money, large money, you know what? To stop the witness of the resurrection.